it's Celia, and I hope you all are doing fine. Today, I would like to do a haul for you. I went to Dublin a couple of weeks ago, and I bought some books. Me and my friend, we are having this annual book trips where we go to different cities, and we visit a lot of bookshops and also other literary things. So it's been, I think, it's been many months since I did a book haul the last time, and that does not mean, by all means, that I haven't bought books, because I am pretty notorious when it comes to buying books quicker than I read them. But I will show you some of my books today. I will also share some photos from Dublin with you at the end of this video, if you'd like to see. For now, I can see that it was an amazing trip. We went to see the Book of Kells at the Trinity College. It was so amazing to see how they made the book. They used calfskin and they wrote every word with feathers. And to see all the little details, all the letters and all the illustrations and all the artwork was just amazing. And we did see the Book of Kells, the original one. It was on display, and yeah, I think it was fantastic. It was also pretty awesome to be in the long room. It's the old library of Trinity College, and the atmosphere, the smell of old books, and everything was just, I just loved it. We also went to the Writers Museum, and it was so interesting to see both the history of literature and the writers, and also how they were impacted by the history of Ireland, because Ireland is a country with a lot of writers and a lot of literature, but also has its history, as all countries have. And I really like to see that connection. And yeah, we went to pubs, we went to bookshops, and we went to the archaeological museum, and the Norwegian Vikings were in Ireland a lot, and it was quite amusing to see the replica of the Oseberg ship, which the real one is in Norway, but it was kind of fun. And yeah, we did see a lot of things that we were really interested about. We also saw the statue of Oscar Wilde and James Joyce. Sadly, the weather was upon us and we had a blizzard or a snowstorm. It was a storm Emma, so it made the whole of Europe very cold. And everything closed down from Thursday, but we are used to snow here. So despite that, we went on this sightseeing on our own, and we saw the Christchurch Cathedral from the outside and the St. Patrick Cathedral, and everything was closed, so we couldn't go inside. And sadly, both the Joyce Center and it was closed, and also the literary pub round was cancelled. So, but that just means that we had to go back another time. So yeah, we were weatherbound on the hotel for some time, and both me and Elizabeth, who I was going with, we do really love to just cuddle up in some chairs and read books, so that was what we did. So all in all, it was a fantastic trip, and I highly recommend you to go to Dublin if you have the chance to do so, because it's really good. And yeah, but back to the books. I will show you some of the books that I bought. I will not show you all of them, but I will show you the Irish ones and also books that I think I will be reading this year. Because I know myself well enough to know that even though I buy books in 2018, it might be some years until I read it. And that's just how I function, I think. But let's get started. Irish ones first. The first one is Nothing on Earth by Conor O'Callaghan. And I don't know anything about this writer, but the synopsis and the blurb on the back really sold me. And this is set in a very hot August month, and a young woman is knocking on the door of this elderly man, and they start to talk. It looks like she is coming back every day, and they talk about things. She talks about her family, and she tells him that her family members are disappearing one by one. And there is this ambiguity that you don't know if she's talking or she's telling the truth, or you don't know if he is telling the truth. And at some point, reality and what's not starts to blur. And I really love stories like that. Also, the blurb says, strange, beautiful, and quietly terrifying. I had to have it. Then I have a book by William Trevor. This is Felicias' Journey. He is a very well-known Irish author. This book in particular is on the 1001 list. I haven't read anything by him either, but I have watched a movie, Felicias' Journey. It was made into a movie in the late 1990s or the early 2000s by Atom Egoyan, and it's a really great movie, so I highly recommend that one. And this is about a young girl. She has fallen in love with this Brit, and she is pregnant. And she really thinks that he loves her as well, so she decides to go from Ireland to England and tell her boyfriend that she is with child. And on this journey, she meets a man. He is called Mr. Hilditch, and he is a collector and a befriender of homeless young girls. So yeah. I have two books by Josephine Hart. Yes. I have Damage and Sin. And both of these books, I was made aware of these books in Paris last summer. I found them in one of my favorite used bookshops there. And I was thinking about buying them, but for some reason I didn't. But when I found out that she was Irish and I was in Dublin, I just had to have them. The first one, Damage, was made into a movie starring Jeremy Irons and Juliette Binoche in the early 1990s. And I didn't make the connection at all when I saw this book and heard about the movie. But I have watched the movie way back, and I didn't make that connection until I saw the movie tie-in cover with Jeremy Irons. And then I started to remember that I had watched it. But this is a book about an elderly man who has an affair with his son's fiancé. And yeah, I think it can be pretty interesting. The other one is Sin, and this is about a woman that is obsessed and very envious of her cousin, and she wants everything that she has. And the first chapter starts with, I never knew her really. I came closest to her through a husband, the man with whom I now live, and through a son whose name was Stephen. And through the lie. So yeah, it seems like quite a sinister book, and I like sinister, so I'm all in. The last Irish book I bought was Bloodroot by Annemarie Churreain. I don't speak or read Irish, so that was 100% wrong, but yeah, this is her name. And this is her debut collection, and I was flipping through it, and I really got fascinated by the first poem. And this is about womanhood. It's about all the women and all the voices that has been muted, and also about the nameless women, but also women that we know the names of. So, yeah. Then I have another collection of poetry called Of Mutability by Jo Shapcott, and this won the Costa Award in 2010. And in this, the author explores the morality and the nature of change, both the changes in the body and in nature, but also the shifting relationships between people. And as I usually do, I read some of the poetry or some of the poems, and here is the one that sold this book to me. Riddle. I am always behind or on top of you, full of dust, ash and air. I smell of every room you ever walk through. I rise when offended, creak when wet. How easily we part, adieu. How often I leave trails of myself in your wake. Yeah. I think I would really enjoy this one. Then I found a non-fiction book, and it's called In the Days of Rain, A Daughter, A Father, A Cult by Rebecca Stott. And I really love to read about cults. I am so fascinated by the concept and why people are joining them, and I really like to dig into it and understand the mechanisms. I have read so many memoirs about being a cult members, and I found them usually to be pretty bad. I'm not sure if they are written too close to the events that I have been out of this community for too shorter of time. I'm not sure. But this won the Costa Book Awards last year, so I hope it's very good. And Rebecca grew up in this Christian sect that believed that the world was ruled by Satan. All the women had to wear headscarves. All books written by non-sect members were banned. And the punishment for breaking the rules was very harsh. And she leaves this sect, but many years later her father reached out to her and he's dying. And he wants her to write his story. So this is both a story about her growing up in this sect, but also about her father and about him also growing up in this cult. And I am really fascinated. And I think this will be the book. Then I have a collection of short stories by Roald Dahl. This is Lust, Tales of Craving and Desire, and I have been reading a lot of Roald Dahl with my kids, and I really love his kids books, but it's been a very long time since I read some of his adult fiction, and I need to do something about that, so I decided on Lust. This is a part of a series, and the other ones are Madness, Deception and Cruelty. And of course, I would like to read them as well. But when in the bookshop, this was the book that spoke to me the most. Then I have Ice by Ana Kavan. And this is a post-nuclear dystopia set in a frozen world. And in this, there is one man pursues the sylph-like silver-haired girl he loves, and she keeps running. Away from her husband, away from the sinister warden who seeks to control her, away from him. And I have heard Agnes from Beyond Epilogue talk about this. Yeah, I'm excited. And then, last but not least, I have L'amour by Marguerite Duras. I love Marguerite Duras, she's my favorite author, and I wasn't aware of this book. And this is the sequel to The Ravishing of Lollstein, which is a book I will be reading later this year. And it really caught me by surprise. It was a pleasant surprise, but still a surprise. And this is about a man called a traveler, and he goes back to a town where he used to spend his time 20 years back. And there he sees a woman called her. And he observes a man called him, and it brings him back to the time where he was engaged to this young woman. It's written, it's very experimental. It's written like a movie script. And I will read you something from the introduction. But the woman in L'Amour is more than Lol Wiestein. She's all of the Duras madwoman distilled into one. She occupies a completely blank canvas, the beach and eerily empty streets of Estala, completing one corner of the strange triangle that comprises the heart of the narrative and dramatic action of the book. I can't wait to read this one. So yeah, that was all my books. No, that was some of the books that I bought in Dublin. And if you've read any of them, please let me know what you thought of them. As usual, I am super curious. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and happy reading.